Digital bank GoTime set to launch automated teller machines or ATMs in March to provide a holistic everyday banking experience for the public. Its executive officer Nate Clark says the firm will initially put up 20 kiosks in Metro Manila and key cities, but they may increase this number depending on demand. The digital lender said the ATMs will be placed in malls, transportation terminals, groceries, central business districts, and tourist spots.
We'll be scaling up over time, dependent on demand. But what we're seeing overall is that the pent-up demand for what we call simple, beautiful banking has actually far exceeded our expectations. We are, 15 months in, we are now the fastest growing bank in the country. We have 2.5 million customers now. This month alone, we'll add 275,000 new customers. And that, I think what's more exciting than the number of customers is the adoption. So we're actually now, we're processing over 15 million transactions per month. And as of last week, we've also jumped into now the top four of all banks in the Philippines, number four on active Visa debit cards. We want to be, by the end of the year, over 5 million. I think we're actually comfortably already on that run rate. But I think we're actually much more focused on delivering that kind of upgraded banking experience. Actually, the vast majority of these customers are not new to banking. They're actually switching from their existing banking relationship.
Speaking of the auto industry, the Philippine government urged to speed up the creation of more infrastructure for electric vehicles. For more on this story, let's bring in our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Hi, Jackie. Go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The Electric Vehicle Association of the Philippines admits that there are still several challenges in beefing up the electric vehicle industry or EV usage in the country. But the group remains optimistic that EV will begin to penetrate the mainstream market in a few years' time. At a media briefing for the Auto Parts and Vehicles Expo 2024, EVAP President or EVAP Assistant Executive Director Neil Lopez said there are still obstacles amid the tax incentives given to EV users. One barrier, he said, is financing, since some banks are still reviewing their loan program for EVs. Some EVs are also still a bit expensive for some users. The Department of Energy said that under the comprehensive roadmap for the electric vehicle industry, the target EVs by 2028 is over 2.4 million units. Now, the number of vehicles as of 2022 is just less than 10,000. EV charging stations, Stanley, the target by 2028 is 66,500. Now, there are only 300-plus charging stations. So EVAP said that there is really a big challenge for them to increase the usage of EVs in the country, but they remain confident that they will reach the targets as soon as demand will rise in the coming months and years. EVAP added that more incentives for the EV industry other than tax breaks can be beneficial to the sector, but admitted too that that may not be possible, especially if the government will give subsidies, and that might not be possible right now because other countries give subsidies to EV users, but it might not happen in the Philippines. The Philippine Automotive Traders Association, Inc., meanwhile, said that they're actually a bit worried of the rise of EV. Its Secretary General Augustus Chua said that EVs need to be studied more carefully since there are safety issues. But he admitted that the sector might be moving towards that direction. And the groups and the different officials here at the press con also mentioned that there needs to help to beef up the infrastructure and other aspects of the EV industry. Stanley, the Auto Parts and Vehicles Expo 2024 will discuss that issue and more, and they had a press conference earlier for their event, which will happen in June this year. And that's the latest. Back to you, Stanley.
All right, thank you so much for the update, Jackie Pascual. The Philippine Energy Department meanwhile warns Filipinos of possible power interruptions amid the El Nino. According to the agency, the country's power grid can supply enough electricity to withstand peak demand of nearly 14,000 megawatts. But problems with transmission systems could trigger power interruptions. The DOE is hoping to complete several transmission projects in the Visayas and Mindanao to support hydropower facilities in Luzon amid the weather event.
ang sanhi po ng outages natin o yung mga nagagiging sanhi ng brownout or blackout ay hindi lang po yung kakulangan ng supply ng kuryente, kundi dahil na rin po kuminsan sa condition po ng ating transmission facilities at maging yung po sa distribution level. Tayo po ay continuous na nakikipag-coordinate sa lahat po natin ng power stakeholders kung saan po ay pinapaalala natin, una po sa ating mga generating facilities, dapat po yung kanilang mga preventive maintenance sa program ay naaayon doon sa tinatawag nating grid operating management program kung saan naka-schedule po ang mga panahon ng kanilang pagpadak ng preventive maintenance.